My lovers, Aquarius Nation and their lovers, welcome to your July 2020 astrological sign update. Now remember, when you're watching these readings for love guys, what am I saying for loves? Maybe your person has a choice between two, who knows? You're not going to just watch your sun sign, okay? You're going to watch your sun, your moon, your Venus, your rising sign, and then you're going to watch your person's placements in those areas. So you can get triangulation, right? And when you get a common message, and you know, you're on it, okay? And then if any title calls to you, especially if it shows up and says recommended on YouTube, that's a message for you. Doesn't matter what astrological sign, it doesn't matter what it is. When it says recommended, that's your spirit guides. There's something there that they want you to know, okay? So let's see what your person's higher self wants to let you know at this time. This is my divine counterpart and separation deck. All right. So they want you to know that this person knows that this is an eternal love, Aquarius. They know this, okay? And it looks like there's cycles that are closing off in your person's life. We have card number 73, which talks about... which boils down, I got lost with another message. I'm going to tell you just now. Let me get the first message. Right, 73 reduced to 10, and 10 is about endings. And then 10 is also reduced to 1, which is about a new cycle beginning, right? But 73 is also the vibrations of 7 and 3. Now, the vibration of 7, that's the divine energy, okay? That's like divine intervention. And 3, it talks about Empress energy, which is about intuition, receiving from the universe. But it could also talk about a third party situation. So it could be that the divine has intervened to push your person into their divine feminine energy, which is them using their intuition, receiving from the universe. Or it could be that the divine has intervened in a third party situation. Okay, it's a vibrations of 3 and 7. 7 is also the chariot, so that's about moving forward. Okay, and then we have the vibrations of 3 again, the Empress. So that's about moving forward and being guided by your intuition. Okay, so either way, your person's been led to the fact that this is an eternal love. They've had some sort of awakening here. I'm seeing this awakening right here. So they've had some sort of awakening, and there's a heart activation that's happening here that's pushing them towards this recognition. We have yes. They're saying yes to transformation. We have this butterfly here. So some of you guys might be dealing with a Scorpio, because this is transformation energy I'm seeing here, and this is transformation energy. So this person is saying yes to this connection. They're saying yes to transformation, and they know that it's going to take a lot for them to stand in their power and transform their life completely, because this is what this eternal love is calling for. Now 38, well, it reduced to 8, so that's a strength card, so they're going to be standing in their power. But 35 is also the vibration of 3 and 5. Again, vibration of 3 is the Empress, so everything here is about the Empress. It's about you, Aquarius, okay? So their mind is on you, but it looks like I'm getting another course correction. So you could probably watch Scorpio. It looks like the divine has intervened again in a third party situation. There's some kind of difficulties here, but it's just to push this person into transformation so they can go back on course. It looks like they went in the wrong direction. That's what I'm seeing here. All right, so let us pull some cards on these just to get further messages, and then we'll move on. So tell us about this eternal love, spirit. Yeah, you see, your person's healing their heart. Another number 5. Wow. They're healing their heart. I think this person, I'm definitely picking up on a karmic. Now, in my readings, all reverse court cards are karmic energies, and all upright court cards are divine energies, okay? So we're picking up on a karmic here. I think this person, now they could have been with a karmic, with a third party, or they could have been in karmic energies where they were not opening up their heart to love. But look, it looks like it got busted open now, though. It got busted open now. Pardon me, guys. This person can express their love or their truth. That's what happened here. Yeah, but it looks like they're realizing you're the soulmate, you're the twin flame. But they are, I'm getting, still resisting transformation. Some of you guys definitely dealing with a Scorpio. Some of you guys dealing with a Cancer. Let me see why they're resisting transformation. They went the wrong way. Some of you guys need to watch Scorpio's reading. They went the wrong way and they got their heart broken, but that had to happen so that it could be cracked open to spirit and for them to come have their complete awakening. Everything had to happen just as it happened. So you might be pissed off at this person because it looks like they went in a different direction, but it had to happen. This was the way it was supposed to happen, for them to go with a third party or to get their heart broken so that they would be wide awake. Let me see this yes card. Yeah, they're taking action. Look him here, the Leo. Taking action here. Okay, so somebody's taking action because they want reconciliation. Look, we have the Six of Cups. Six of Cups talks about soulmate. Six of Cups talks about reconciliation. Six of Cups talks about past lives. Yeah, and look, we have the Twin Flame card here, the Four of Wands. So this person knows that, listen, this is an eternal love. This is some kind of Twin Flame shit. And look, the Empress right here. They know you're the Empress. Look at right here. So everything is about the Empress. They are focused on this Empress. They are focused on transformation. They're focused on change. And this person's made the decision to change. All right, let's go into this person's emotional body now. This is my deck as well, emotional intelligence. Let's have a look. I'm going to get three cards and see what's going on with your person. All right, so they're in some kind of stalemate energy. We're going to find out why. And I see here, they're in victim mode. I think they went the other way and this person broke their heart. Okay, so they're in victim mode now. And they're feeling vengeful. Whoa. All right, so it looks like they broke your heart and then somebody broke theirs. I mean, it's karma. I don't understand. It's karma, guys. It's karma. You can't run from it. It's got everybody's address, right? Yeah, so they're trying to move on from some kind of stalemate energy. I think this person was confused as to what direction they should be heading in, but there's been intervention from spirit. I told you the vibrations of 7 and 3. So look, we have 7 here. They're moving on from some kind of stalemate energy. I think your person has been overthinking things, paranoid, thinking about all the things that can go wrong, which is the negative aspect of Virgo, and this is a Virgo here, right? So they're trying to move on from that energy there. Yeah, because they were with some kind of third party, and it was karmic. They were meant to be with this person. There was karma to be resolved here, okay? So it was karmic, and, you know, them being there with the karmic kind of held up this connection somewhat, but it looks like everything is being released right now. The karma, it looks like the karmic debt has been paid. Let's see victim mode. Why are you person in victim mode? Yeah, you see, I told you, they got their karma. I don't see why they thought they could have gotten away with it. Okay, they got their karma. Play stupid games, get stupid presents. Sorry, I don't mean to offend anybody, but just, you know, it's the way the world works. We all get it. We all get it. When we don't act with integrity or anything like that, we get it. Okay? So it looks like somebody has received their karma. They're the victim now. They're the victim. Absolutely stressed out. We see them here in the 9 of Swords energy. And they're stressed out about money. I think the person went in another direction because they thought it would be more bountiful. And it wasn't so. So it looks like they got their heart broken, and it looks like either somebody stole money from them or they lost finances in that whole transaction. And I'm going to call it a transaction because that's exactly what it was. It was not based on love. It was based on what each person can get from it. So it was a transaction. So as coldly as it came together, it's as coldly as it's fallen apart. Yeah, they want revenge here. They're not doing anything just yet, but they're vengeful. Okay. I think there's some kind of relationship that's breaking apart for them right now. They're seeing the truth about everything. And the truth that they really download is that they never loved this person, this karmic that they were with. They just went there or they ran away from you because this person had abandonment issues. Mm-hmm. They had abandonment issues. But this is sounding like the Scorpio reading. So you should just log on to the Scorpio reading as well, because that's what it's sounding like. All right. Let's go into the Kipper deck and find out exactly what's happening in your person's life, why they're coming out like this in this spread. So let's see what's going on here. What's happened? Why are they in victim mode? Why do they want vengeance? What's going on? But it looks like karma to me, guys. Yeah, they're concerned. What are they concerned about? Now 3-3, that's master number 33, that talks about your spiritual gifts. So it looks like your person having an awakening, and it kind of bothering them because they may not understand fully what's going on. 3-3 also reduces to 6, and 6 about love. So they're concerned about their choices in love. They're concerned if they can get back to you. All right, look, we have, what did I tell you about somebody stealing their money? Look, we have thief here. Somebody stabbed them in the back. Mm-hmm. That's what happened. Somebody stabbed them in their back. But it looks like, it looks like they're going to get out of this situation, though. We have a card number 11. Things are returning to balance. It looks like there's been a divine intervention. The scales have been balanced. And look, this karmic here. This is a karmic in this deck. I haven't named her the karmic. Right? The privileged lady. So we're going to find out what's going on with the privileged lady. Whatever happened, it changed your person's perspective of this privileged lady. Now, this karmic doesn't necessarily have to be a female, okay? This could be family members. This could even be a mom or a father energy, okay? Or a sibling that stabbed them in the back. But somebody betrayed somebody. Let me see the thief. Yes. Whatever happened here, it really stole your person's self-confidence. Look, we have the Six of Wands in reverse and we have the Four of Cups in reverse. Six of Wands talks about a lack of confidence. And Four of Cups reverse talks about a fear of rejection. Okay, I want to accept your cup of love, but I'm afraid of being rejected. So your person, whatever happened here, whatever loss that was incurred here, it really took a toll on your person's self-esteem and on their ego. It looks like somebody stole something from them, some kind of money or something like that. And it looks like it's this karmic. Like this karmic was distracting. That's what I'm getting. The karmic was distracting your person while somebody else shafted them in the back. So the karmic could have had someone else, or there could be some kind of betrayal related to a child. But the karmic was distracting your person with sex while somebody relieved them of what was precious to them. But it looks like your person's loving themselves, and it looks like some kind of secret was revealed. And I think the secret was, it could be the karmic was juggling, was in another situation. Okay? But we have sudden wealth. So it looks like your person's suddenly figuring out their worth. And it looks like they may have even gotten a financial windfall. So they are manifesting a new beginning for themselves. Okay? Yeah, they're healing their heart. We have the Five of Cups in reverse. And they're awake. Look at them here. They want a new beginning in love. Because they know that you guys are in eternal love. But let's see what they're doing about this karmic here. Yeah, they know they went the wrong way with this karmic. They know they went the wrong way. And it looks like this karmic broke their heart. Look, we have the Five of Swords here. Yeah, but this was karma. The Star card reverse is a card of karma. This was all karma. This is exactly what was supposed to happen. There was a karmic debt between them. And also, this happened for your person to finally stand in their power and stand up to the karmic. Because previously, they gave their power away to this karmic. Okay? All right. So let's go into the tarot now. And I'm going to find out what your person's thinking with regard to you. Okay, I'm going to be using the Mermaid Tarot by Dame Darcy. We have the Empress. I told you everything. Sorry, guys. Everything is about the Empress. Everything is about the Empress. This is the energy of this reading. All right. So when your person thinks about you and thinks about this connection, we have the strength card. You make them feel strong. You know, you are the one that's inspiring them to stand in their power and to stand up for themselves. Okay, I think previously this person was giving their power away, and it's a self-esteem issue. I'm going to clarify for you guys. So we have Leo coming out there. We have the King of Cups. We have a Scorpio. Right, so this person is in love. And we have a Knight of Pentacles in reverse, Virgo. Oh my gosh, the overthinker again. Okay, so what's going on? Your person, you're inspiring them to stand in their power. Know that this person has deep, deep feelings for you, Aquarius. Deeper than the ocean. Deep feelings for you. And look, there's this dolphin here. So Spirit is letting you know that this love is protected, okay? This is Two of Cups. We have the Two Cups here. This is protected, all right? And there's going to be healing here. I'm seeing two stars as well, okay? But your person, every time they think about coming towards you, Aquarius, they keep on overthinking. Look, we have paranoia here with this Knight of Pentacles in reverse. They think about everything that can go wrong. Maybe you don't want to talk to them. Maybe it's not going to work out. Everything I can think that can go wrong, this person thinks about it. This person thinks about it. It's, you know, instead of just trusting your intuition, which is what Spirit wants them to do, they think about everything that may have gone wrong. Good Lord. Yeah, tower moment. Everything that may have gone wrong in the past and everything that could go wrong in the future, that's what they think about. So let's clarify. Let's see the Strength card here. Yeah, they are standing in their power and they're releasing the things that no longer serve them. We have this Four of Pentacles in reverse. Okay, they want to be vulnerable, they want to open up their heart, but they know before they even approach you, there's some kind of third party that they must release. Okay, so that's what they're doing. I think your person gained a lot of emotional maturity by being in that karmic relationship, whatever setup it was, whether it was a job, family members, whatever it was. They gained a lot of emotional maturity and they're now realizing exactly who they love and what love is. I think before, previously, they were trapped. They were trapped in their mind and they were so unhappy. Okay? Yeah, they couldn't see the truth of their circumstances. They couldn't see how karmic the situation was, how unbalanced the situation was. But now they're setting themselves free and they're moving on from a situation that really was quite toxic. Let's get a Knight of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, this person, I think they have a tendency to overthink. They are naturally paranoid, but it looks like they're getting some kind of mental clarity here with that Two of Swords reverse. Yeah, I think your person may battle with depression naturally, okay? Or they get stressed out very easily. But this is pushing them, though. All this energy is pushing them to manifest something new in love here and to love themselves completely. They only gave their power away because they did not love themselves. They didn't think that they were worthy of love. All right, so this is vibing with you. You can join me in extended. I'm there. I'm going to look at this person's heart space energy for you. What they might be hiding from you. Any blockages to the connection. I'm going to get some 3D messages from them with this big deck here. I'm also going to get some messages from their higher self. I'm going to look at potential actions towards you by the end of the month. And then I'll get an advice card for you. Okay, Aquarius? All right, guys. Thank you so much for your likes, shares, subscribes, and your comments down below. And if you can go a step further and interact with any of the ads that may play during this reading, that's a beautiful energy exchange. Okay, Aquarius? All right, guys. Take care. Bye.